unlike the Rhino rack and the ARB, stuff like that, you can mount with just 2 points. Technically, you could mount this with 2 points, but the hinge has to be supported. So you have to remember that when you have something like a Front Runner mount or a Rhino rack, Pioneer rack, or any of these racks, you have to be able to support this hinge part first and foremost. I didn't do that. I made a mistake. I didn't really do a whole lot of research. I had talked to the guys at OK Four-Wheel Drive, and they let me know it's not an issue. Like, I should have really looked into it before I just randomly bought an awning. But I was able to weld up a mount so that it would support it, and now it's totally different. There's no deflection, no twisting. It's a night and day difference in the performance of the awning. The other kind of issue, but not really, is the retention on the far end of it. What it comes with is basically, it's designed to work with their truck caps or their campers or anything like that. It bolts to the side, goes around, they give you a little bracket to rivet on to the camper or shell and be done. It works. It's a perfectly useful situation. No, that won't work for what I'm doing. So now, for now, I'm just doing this, you know, cam lock strap, so I don't put any unnecessary holes in it and make something work for what I have now. Because in June, when the new sliding camper gets here, it'll just work how it's supposed to. But overall, I'm stoked to have this awning. Just like the Foxwing and waiting for so long to get it, I can't believe that I did wait this long to get something without poles. It is super nice. As long as you can mount it, pay somebody to mount it, or rig something up for yourself, it's so worth it. So here's the awning as you see it. It's mounted to a bed rack mount that I made. I had to add this because the hinge right here has to be supported, all that jazz. I don't have to modify this because once I get the camper, it's gonna go straight to the camper, so there's no need to do a whole bunch of crap. So this will work for now, but it's totally self-supporting, and you can see it's got almost no movement whatsoever. I know some people were kind of worried about the mount that I made, but I'm not at all. There is close to minimal flex with huge amounts of pulling. But for now, I mean, I give the Alucab awning, I mean, I can't give it like a 10 out of 10 or like a 12 out of 10, but I'm gonna put a solid at an 8 out of 10. I think everything has a quirk. You can't really, it's not perfect due to the difficulty of mounting unless you have something like a solid side cab or, you know, you can fab something. It's gonna be a difficult mounting solution for some people. That is something that you have to keep in mind. But if you put in the effort to do the mount, if you put in the time to get it on your rig, you're going to be completely happy with it. I mean, it's there's nothing faster to put out. I certainly recommend it. The guys at OK Four-Wheel Drive are the importer for them for the U.S., so go hit them up. You know, it's awesome. I'll be getting the walls here soon. I mean, it's a big chunk of money, so I kind of got to space it out a little bit. We use the walls a lot camping, so for us, it's worth it. We need a place to take a shower, a place to relax, change, stuff like that. But if you have any questions, you know, feel free to drop me a message. We're brovelanding_Tacoma on Instagram. Or you can shoot me an email or YouTube message, drop, you know, in the comments, whatever. We're working on a new site. It's going to be broverlanding.com. We'll document the build of the Tacoma as well as our adventures there. And you know, if anybody's in Florida, you don't want to hang out at the beach, you want to go, you know, hit Ocala, some trails, drop me a line. I'd be more than happy to come out and go with you. I know a couple good camping spots in Ocala, but I'm sure there's some guys out there that know even better ones. You know, let's get together and let's make a video. Have a great day, guys.